The Wheel's Spinning, 6:30 tonight.
This is Eyewitness News with Floyd Kalber, Steve Deschler's weather, Tim Weigel on sports, and the Eyewitness News team.
Good evening, Chicago. It's two down and one to go, and we'll have a World Series in Chicago. The Cubs did it again today. They beat the Padres at Wrigley Field. Right now, the Cubs are getting ready to leave for California, where they're going to finish the playoff series. Today's game was more defense than big hits, but victory was just as sweet as the Cubs took game two of the National League playoffs. The Cubs, now accustomed to winning, seem to take it all in stride, but the fans simply went wild. And the final score, Chicago 4, San Diego 2. Kim Peterson is out at Wrigley Field, where the Cubs are preparing at this moment to board buses for O'Hare Airport. Kim, what's going on?
How you doing, Floyd? You know what, you're right, because it's the fans and the members of the news media who are going crazy about this win today, and actually crazy about the fact the Cubs got here at all, being so excited for them. But the Cubs players are not downplaying it, but they're being very, very cautious not to get too overly excited. Stranger things have happened when a team was down 0-2 like the Padres are. They could come back. The Cubs know that. They know they're a good ball club. But talk about fan excitement. Right down behind me here on Waveland, on the outside of the park on the north side, those are fans down there gathered just to try to get a glimpse through the smoke-covered windows of the buses of the Cubbies as they come out of the locker room and board those buses right now. There are a lot of Cubs players on there now. They'll be leaving any minute now for the airport, where their charter flight leaves at 7 o'clock to go on to San Diego. And the fans just cannot get enough of these Cubs. They've been out there since the game was over just to see if they could get a peek at some of the Cubs players. The Cubs excited about this coming up contest later on this week in San Diego. But the Cubs are really looking forward to putting away the Padres tomorrow night.
One thing we can't do is go out there to San Diego and you know, take them and, you know, just be relaxed. We can't do that. We're going to go at them like we want to get this thing over as quick as possible. We can come back and have a few days off, and we can look at the Tigers and the Royals play a few games, and we can get some rest ourselves, because it's been a long year. And myself right now, I think I can have a couple of days off as far as swinging that bat, get some things together. But, you know, we could clinch it tomorrow. That would be outstanding for us.
We're not ready to bury them. We still need one more win, and they have a lot of pride and a lot of veteran ball players over there, and they do have their backs up against the wall, but we've been there, maybe not to this extent, but when you're in that position, you tend to play maybe even better and definitely harder. So we want to keep the same intensity level and go out there and hopefully close it out tomorrow night.
Well, once again, it's the fans who are going crazy, and the Cubs are showing an awful lot of class with all this pressure, all this media attention, and they're handling this very, very well. I think that is a credit to some of the older players on the club, as well as a guy like Jim Fry and Dallas Green, who know how to win. They've been there before, and it's a feeling that permeates this entire ball club, from the coaches and the players, the bat boys. Everybody is just very, very excited about this team, but they're holding it down. When the time comes, they'll go crazy like they did that very special Monday night when we had a chance to be in Pittsburgh and watch the Cubs go bananas in the locker room. Anyway, the bus leaves in just a couple of minutes, a couple of charter buses to the airport, a 7 o'clock flight. They'll be in San Diego at 9 o'clock, and then tomorrow night on Channel 7 we will have the game 3, which may be the deciding game to put the Cubs for the first time in 39 years into the World Series. Live along Waveland at Wrigley Field, I'm Kim Peterson, Channel 7 Eyewitness News. Floyd.
Thank you, Kim. Next time I hope you can get a little more enthusiastic about it.
I'll do my best.
Too bad the Cubs can't take all their fans with them to California. Today, their enthusiasm, as usual, was contagious. And Marianne Childers has that story. Marianne?
Thank you, Floyd. A big contrast on this side of Wrigley Field. The crowd has thinned out. Most everybody's gone home. It's very quiet. It's almost back to normal. Normal being before Cubs fever gripped the Wrigleyville area. All the fans have gone home except for a handful, including the fans who've been waiting outside for so long. The outsiders who didn't have tickets to these two wonderful playoff games. You know, Floyd, for the people who were outside, any seat on the inside would have been a great seat.
Another gate open over here.
All right.
No complaints today from those in the bleachers, although they weren't the Wrigley regular bleacher bums. Instead of t-shirts, lots of white shirts and suits. No matter if the employees are playing hooky, the boss probably is too. Among the faithful fans were the famous. Chicago favorite Bobby Vinton sang the national anthem.
And the home of the brave.
Our Padres. Padre Busters were cheered on by a real live Ghostbuster, actor Bill Murray.
How's it going?
Billy Goat Tavern owner Sam Sianis was in his seat, but without the goat today. And while many Chicago journalists were covering the Cubs,
we've had the character-building joy of defeat. Now we want the decadence of victory.
Outside, those who missed the game were still entertained as they shared the spirit of the ballpark. Saxophone players and jugglers, some bursting with Cubs fever, others just taking advantage of this captive crowd. Steve Dahl and Gary Meyer debuted on WLS AM radio, live from the ballpark.
The guy that we're going to have out in San Diego, around the station, he looks normal.
And we should point out the Cubs weren't the only winners. The vendors, the souvenir sellers who were outside of Wrigley Field did okay. This was the view if you took the CTAL to the ballpark this afternoon. Sort of a street carnival, a movable circus, lots of things to buy. Well, now at this late hour, all the souvenir vendors have folded up their T-shirts, they've rolled up the banners, and they've gone home. One last note, Floyd. I've been watching the air over the ballpark. I think Wrigley Field is probably on a flight path to and from O'Hare. But, you know, it seems like this afternoon those big commercial jets are flying awfully low. Maybe those pilots are just giving all the passengers a little view of Wrigley Field, where so much has happened that's so important to Chicago. Well, our Cubs are headed to San Diego. I'm going to head back to the station. Floyd, back to you in the studio.
Thank you, Marianne. Great job. The Cubs are working very hard for their success, but they're making it very hard for all of us to do our work. The temptation is the strongest at the colleges around the state, where Chicago students are more worried about hits than homework. Alan Krashesky with that story.
It could be any bar in Chicago, but it's not. In fact, these Cub fans are more than 60 miles away from Wrigley Field in DeKalb, Illinois. But they're diehard Cub fans wherever they're from.
They're going to kill San Diego. And then whoever they play next, I hope they can do as best as they can.
Sure, it's a work day, but don't tell that to the students, store owners, or even the local undertaker. They're all here with the Cubs. Work can wait.
Are you normally open nurse time? And in other words,
we're open. I'm just not there.
Oh, so your business is open, but you're watching a Cubs game.
That's right.
But there's nothing wrong with that.
Well, they know the number. They can call me if they need me.
Here at Northern Illinois University, even the Huskies are playing second fiddle to the Cubbies. And the only homework assignment on the minds of many students is to learn how well the Cubs are doing.
All over campus, the soap operas are off and the Cubs are on. All eyes on the hits and the outs.
You got 10 minutes before a big accounting exam and you're here watching the Cubs?
Right.
either you're very good in accounting or you're a pretty big Cubs fan.
Hopefully a little of both.
Jane Farmer may be the biggest fan on campus. She's a library assistant, but her office could be a Cubs shrine.
This is our way of paying tribute to a great team of 84.
Even the men in Sigma Nu are saluting the men in blue. And like one student says, you have to have priorities. And they're the Cubs. Alan Krashesky, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
Other news coming up, another major Chicago bank is in financial trouble. And dozens of kids are suspended from school because their parents didn't go to church.
What shall I be on, 5 or 7?
Rags has a wonderful way.
How about spaghetti for dinner, topped with zesty meat sauce, a tossed green salad with croutons, and toasted garlic roll? Or chicken, golden fried boneless breast pieces, served with choice of sauce, deep fried wedge cut potatoes, and toasted garlic roll. Chicken or spaghetti dinner, only $2.99 all this month at Wags.
No wonder folks love Wags.
This is what most countertops are made of. And this is DuPont Corian. In time, this could be cut or stained, but Corian will keep its good looks. It's this much thicker, and the beauty goes clear through, so you can remove stubborn stains like cigarette burns, even sand out accidental cuts, and your Corian will still look like new. For kitchen, for bath, for solid beauty that lasts, Corian at better kitchen and bath dealers.
One of Chicago's most controversial priests is back in the news again. Father George Clements suspended 200 students at Holy Angel School because their parents missed Mass last Sunday. Jim Avila with that story.
These parents were called into school this morning not to talk about their children's behavior, but their own. The children were suspended from Holy Angels Catholic School when their parents failed to show up for church on Sunday. None missed class this morning, but they were not allowed back in the school until their parents received a lecture from the school administrator, Father Clements.
They sign a contract at the beginning of the school year stating that they are going to attend Mass on Sunday. And if they do not attend, well then, of course, we will suspend them.
Clements says he has parents sign the agreement to attend church so they can give the proper background of their children at home. And he has monitors assigned to check attendance at Sunday Mass.
I think it's fair, you know, because a lot of us have a problem with getting to Mass, but I agree with it.
I'm going to take her out. I can't deal with it. I really can't. The pressures are too much. Pressure is just too much. Suspending a child because you don't attend church, I feel that the child's education is more important than us getting a spiritual background.
Father Clements will lose some of his students because of his strict rules, but he can afford his ironclad policy because there is a waiting list here, 1,000 students long. On the South Side, Jim Avila, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.
Six teenagers in northwest suburban Barrington Hills are accused this evening of terrorizing that affluent suburb with a series of commando-type raids. The police say the teens, dressed in camouflage fatigues, and staged midnight raids, stealing stereos and TVs from homes and cars. They were armed, but no one was hurt in any of the raids. The police say the teenage commandos are responsible for 90% of the recent crimes in Barrington Hills over the past year and a half. First National Bank, Chicago's biggest bank, is admitting to some big problems, but it promises its financial condition is still strong. Andrew Leckie now with details.
Floyd, First National Bank of Chicago today said it has suffered major loan losses. Now, First National's situation is not a near failure. Your deposits are not endangered. If anything, its disclosures indicate more open, conservative actions prompted by Continental Bank's woes and government pressure.
Our team is a strong one, and we will continue to keep winning the innings and ultimately the game as we have in the past.
First National's third quarter loss could be as great as $74 million, though it should show a profit for the year. Loan losses are $279 million, five times that of the prior quarter. It is making a provision for possible future losses of better than $300 million, much involving loans to third world countries. First National's loan problems in the United States are in energy and agriculture. Its foreign problems include shipping and construction. Chairman Sullivan sent a letter to employees referring to troubled Continental Bank. He said, "I would not want you to somehow imagine that there are any similarities." The comptroller of the currency will monitor First National's asset planning.
Our clear hope is that the markets take us at our word. We're saying that this is a one-time event and we've really done a complete portfolio review.
First Chicago stock dropped 3 1/8 to just over $20. 1.5 million shares were trading. The bad news sent the Dow Jones average into a tailspin, tumbling 8.5 points in strong trading. Nearly all bank stocks were down. Finally, today was groundbreaking for the $200 million expansion of McCormick Place. When completed in 1986, the facility west of the current building will add 500,000 square feet. Conventioners had better bring their walking shoes when that expansion is completed. Floyd?
Thank you, Andrew. Cubs are making Chicago happy, so is Steve Deschler. We'll be along shortly with another great forecast.
Today is Judgment Day at Benihana. Master chefs were asked to create frozen entrees for your home as good as those for a restaurant. Each will judge the other's accomplishments. 8 restaurant classics. Like oriental chicken with mushrooms, oriental vegetables with shrimp, oriental broccoli and beef. Benihana frozen restaurant classics. We were either going to make them great or we weren't going to make them at all.
Now, at your AMC Jeep Renault dealer, it's the ones to watch clearance time. Featuring dealer incentives on the ones to watch. Renault Alliance, Renault Encore, incentives of $800 on Fuego Turbo. Plus clearance deals on Jeep CJ, Jeep Cherokee, and more. It's a great time to buy, but hurry before time runs out.
See all the Renault products at your Chicagoland, Northern Indiana AMC Jeep Renault dealer.
Look, there's Rita Moreno. I loved her in 9 to 5.
Oh, it's Sally Struthers, Gloria from All in the Family.
Now, I hear they're coming to town and Neil Simon's The Odd Couple.
Who's playing Felix and Oscar?
They are, only this time it's Florence and Olive.
Rita and Sally? Mm-hmm. It sounds hilarious.
It's an all-new and frankly female version of the Neil Simon classic.
Rita Moreno and Sally Struthers and Neil Simon's The Odd Couple.
I'll get the tickets.
Oh, I'll get the tickets.
Well, we could call for the tickets.
Coming to the Schubert Theater, call 1-800-233-3123. Today in the United States, hospital costs continue to rise faster than the cost of living. But there is a way to reverse this trend that is already working in several states. It's called fair payment, a system where hospitals receive fair preset payments from everyone. Fair payment, a proven way to contain rising hospital costs, supported by America's life and health insurance companies.
More of the same, please.
It's amazing. Just today, rock slides because of heavy rains in Utah, record cold in the south, but it's a charmed existence for the friendly confines. One more sensational day there today. Here's a look at the current satellite shot. This is how things look around here from 22,000 miles out in space. Lots of clear skies, only a few very, very high, pleasant-looking cirrus clouds. Nothing to deter the airplanes and helicopters circling Wrigley Field today. The high temperature was a nice pleasant 73, above normal for this time of the year, as was our low for a change, above normal at 51. Right now at 69. The winds are from the north at 10 miles an hour. The barometer is on the rise. It's a nice, comfortable humidity level of 28%. Knollwood, 62. Montgomery at 70. Glenwood, 71. Lakeland at 60. 63 Midway, the lakefront, 61. Of course, O'Hare at 69 degrees. Here's the current satellite picture that shows the high sort of slicing by the Great Lakes, causing a little front to push down around the area today. Warm high pressure in the south. A big mass of moisture out in parts of the southwest and the Rockies caused by tropical storm Polo, which pushed across Mexico and brought moisture from the Pacific. Here's a look at the radar plot of Weather Service sites out there that shows the rains across the Rockies and the southwestern desert states. Thursday's forecast map shows more precipitation here. A rather pleasant day here, once again, as warm air is on our doorstep, temperatures in the 70s. How's the game going to be for San Diego, you ask me, tomorrow night? Well, the forecast for the Cubs out there will be San Diego, fair skies and temperatures at 65 to around 70 degrees, no rain threat at all. That's all inland across the Rockies and in parts of the southwest. Here's our forecast then for tonight, first of all, calling for mainly partly cloudy skies. Northeast winds around 6 to 12, low temperature at 49 degrees. For tomorrow, sunshine and pleasant weather. Southeast winds around 6 to 12, low temperature 62, lakefront, rather high in the lakefront 62, and high temperature outlying 72. Tomorrow night, increasing clouds by dawn, south winds around 5 to 10, and low temperature at 52. Then for the following day, Friday, some clouds in, showers will be here late, south winds around 10 to 15, and the high temperature at 70. The Cubs will be out of town, and oddly enough, there could be a chance of rain for us this weekend.
Only at night.
We'll see about that.
Work on that.
Polish up your clubs.
Tim Weigel is next from Wrigley Field. He's going to take a look at win number two and the key plays of the game.
But he'll have the play and make the catch.
Tell your customers if they can find the identical item elsewhere for less within 30 days. Wix will refund the difference. Make sure they know that if they're not happy with their furniture when they get it home, Wix will take it back, and that we'll give them a 5-year warranty against manufacturer's defects in workmanship. Now, I can say that a million times on television, but you've got to say it to your customers so that they know at Wix we guarantee our prices, our quality, and their total satisfaction.
Jody Davis for the Video King.
This holiday season, I'll be catching all the fun and excitement with the new video recorder and camera that I got from the Video King.
This weekend only, get 8-hour VHS decks by RCA, Panasonic, and Quasar, all priced below $399. And the new Lloyd's front-load VHS, only $366. 19-inch color TVs, $199. Buy an RCA or Mitsubishi big screen right now and make no payments till January. Sale positively ends Sunday, only at the Video King.
I'm so glad you told me about Heritage Bank. Now that I'm handling everything by myself, I really need all the help I can get. And I feel I can really trust the people at Heritage for advice, for support, just like an old friend.
Studying all the alternatives and making intelligent decisions about money takes a lot of time. That's why I bank at Heritage. It's their job, and they do it very well. Otherwise, I couldn't be here.
Make it easy on yourself. Bank at Heritage.
Tim Weigel is at Wrigley Field at this very moment, where the Cubs are leaving for their trip to San Diego. Tim, what's the latest out there?
Well, the latest is, Floyd, the Cubs are on the bus and they're on the way to O'Hare for a charter flight to San Diego, where they plan to wrap up this National League playoff series out there tomorrow night. They took a good step toward wrapping it up today at Wrigley Field. Just like yesterday, the Cubs took charge in the very first inning. Bob Dernier got him a run. Then they got a big hit in the third inning. Ron Say, the Penguin, the man with playoff and World Series experience with the Dodgers. He's making it happen now for the Cubs. He drives this one in the alley. Good coaching at third base by Don Zimmer. He says the Cubs already have a lead. Let's send Keith Moreland anyway, and it's all of a sudden 2-0 as the throw skips by Terry Kennedy. Steve Trout, very strong today. 8 1/3 innings, allowed only 5 hits. He had the sinker ball working. Here he retires Steve Garvey in the 9th inning. He does it all by himself, runs it over to Bull Durham. He gave way to Lee Smith, and the Cubs came out with a 4-2 triumph. It was exciting. Mike Adamly and I sat and watched it. we're running out of superlatives, but the Cubs look absolutely unstoppable right now.
Well, I think there's one key, Tim. You know, like it has been all season long, the Cubs' offense has been predicated on aggressiveness, not just at the plate, but on the bases as well during these first two playoff games. Today, a perfect case in point, the Cubs jumped out in front early, and triggering the charge was the dynamic daily double combination of Bob Dernier and Ryan Sandberg.
I struggled to get a jump to try to steal, and Thurman has a deceptive move, and Rhino hit the ball, and I was running, so I peeked, and Salazar really didn't look at me, so I just kept on running. And Garvey doesn't have the best arm in the league. He's a very attentive first baseman, though, and he was expecting. I think he pretty good throw on the base, but I just had too good a jump.
Bob, that set the tone for the whole game. You get them going like that, that's what you've been doing all year long, and it set the Cubs up as being completely in control.
Well, that's part of our plan. We want to try to get ahead early, regardless of the method. And when we get ahead early and Rainbow's throwing ground balls, Smitty comes out of the pen, closes the door. It was an outstanding win for us, really. Everybody contributed, and we're real happy to be leaving here 2-0.
And he's done that several times this year. If he's running on the 3-2 count and there's a ball hit to deep third or deep short and they make the long throw across the infield, Dernier's the kind of guy that can get to third base on most first basemen.
Was that a key as far as you're concerned?
It was a very big thing for us to jump out front, I thought, today. What yesterday's game did to influence today's, I didn't think was very much. However, when you jump out ahead today, then, of course, you hope that that has some effect on the other ball club.
I'm sure it's had an effect on the
Padres. Manager Jim Fry is not much for statistics, yeah. But this statistic, I think, tells the tale of the first two games. In addition to Sutcliffe and Trout, the Padres, Allen Wiggins and Tony Gwynn, their leadoff hitters are 2 for 16. They've scored 2 runs. Dernier and Sandberg, 8 for 14, and they have scored 7 of the Cubs' 17 runs in these first two games, and that's been a big difference.
It sure has, Mike. You know, you have to wonder how the Padres feel now. They've been shellacked 2 games. We talked to some of the Padre players about their reaction going into San Diego down 2 games. Let's listen to what they had to say.
We can't wait around for them to give us something. We have to try to take charge and turn around. We're going back in our own park, and there could be no tomorrow. Each one could be the end.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to going back. That's where we've played some great baseball this year, and we've got our 10th player, the fans behind us. Looking forward to playing in front of them tomorrow night.
Steve Garvey looks a little flat, doesn't he? I think, Mike, it's pretty obvious it's going to be the Cubs against the Tigers in the World Series. What a great series that's going to be. Last night, the Tigers jumped all over Kansas City. We've got Rick Sutcliffe. They have who?
Jack Morris, right. The man who no-hit the Sox last season. He is their ace. He can get the job done, too. And like the San Diego Padres, although it's not proving out so far, like you mentioned, Tim, the Tigers and the Cubs match up very well. Watch this great catch up here by Kirk Gibson, a la Keith Moreland in yesterday's game.
Right, very similar. Bases loaded. It's unbelievable, the parallels. And, of course, we keep hearkening back to 1945 when the Cubs and Tigers played in that World Series. That, of course, a home run by Larry Herndon, and Alan Trammell had a couple. So we really got a lot to be excited about. What are we going to do for an encore?
Two great ballparks, Tiger Stadium and Wrigley Field, and a lot of power on both teams.
And, of course, we have the Sting tonight going for the Soccer Bowl Championship. They're playing up in Toronto, and we'll have highlights tonight at 10. You're going to catch a plane to San Diego, and then I'm going to be joining them out there. Floyd, I don't know if we can keep track of all this stuff that's going on now. We're really getting at loose ends.
Well, Timmy, I want to say thanks to you two and to everybody who's worked that story out there. It's been a tough assignment, and you've done great work.
Well, Floyd, it's an easy job to do when it's so exciting.
Thank you. Thank you. We'll be right back.
AM Any time is right for savings from Juul. Start your day with sunshine. Serve Tropicana Gold in pure orange juice. Two cartons are $3. Treat your lunchtime crew to Booth fish sticks. The 32-ounce budget pack is $2.49. What's for dinner? How about a thick, juicy Juul sirloin steak? Just $1.69 a pound. Enjoy these round-the-clock values through Wednesday at Juul.
Presenting panties with a purpose. The purpose? To make you look like this. The name? Something Else Panties by Bally. They do something for your figure regular panties can't do. Something Else Panties have a special fabric to firm, trim, shape you comfortably. So while your panties are probably just sitting there doing nothing, our panties do something. Something Else. The panties with a purpose.
Looks like somebody's taking some Little Debbie snack cakes to work.
My dad.
Oh.
He works very hard, and he gets real...
snack hungry?
Yeah.
Well, what kind are you giving him?
A Star Crunch.
For when he gets snack hungry?
Uh-huh, and a Nutty Bar.
Oh, for dessert. But where are you going to put his sandwich?
I guess I better make room for it.
Whenever you get snack hungry, Little Debbie has a snack for you.
I better make a little more room.
Your Dodge dealer is opening the door to a new era. Announcing the only 5-year or 50,000-mile truck protection plan in America. It covers engine, powertrain, and outer body rust-through on every domestic truck Dodge builds. Not Ford, not Chevy, only Dodge. And it's no extra charge. Is this the beginning of the best year yet? If you're at a Dodge dealer, you bet.
See your Chicago area and Northwest Indiana Dodge dealer 40 strong across Chicagoland.
For a look at what's coming up tonight after the American League playoff game, here's John Drury.
Floyd, tonight after the Detroit-Kansas City game, it's go west, young man, for our winning Cubs as they move their playoffs to San Diego. We'll be at O'Hare as the team and their fans leave for game number 3. Tonight, parents of students in the biggest black Catholic church and parish in Chicago line up to talk to Father Clements and get their hands slapped for not attending Mass with their kids who are bounced from school today. We'll have that and aliens from another dimension invade our planet in the movie The Adventures of Buckaroo Banzai. Roger Ebert reviews that tonight on the 10 o'clock news, Floyd. Buckaroo Banzai. I said it.
That's our news at 6. I'm Floyd Kalber. Have a safe evening.
One, two, clear for takeoff.
Allied knows which way the aerospace industry is going. Which way the automotive industry is going. And the healthcare industry. And the electronics industry. That's why we got into them. At Allied, we mean business.
Professionals get the big job, so I get Quickie. The Quickie Automatic Sponge Mop is the original. For me, it comes true every time. And my time is money, so I demand cleaning power. And oh, so easy ringing. And quick sponge refills. Ta-da! Another sparkling performance. So get Quickie, powerful tools for cleaning.
The original automatic sponge mop.
At these fine stores.
Susan Hayward, Darren McGavin, midnight tonight.
Look at this studio, filled with glamorous prizes, fabulous and exciting merchandise, including something for everyone in this $19,000 TV room showcase. For the man who wants to make a statement, these $1,400 cufflinks. And dazzle her with diamonds with these $6,700 ear clips. Over $101,000 just waiting to be won on Wheel of Fortune. And now, here's your host, Pat Sajak.
Thank you, Jack. Thanks, everybody. Thank you very much.
And welcome again to Wheel of Fortune. And now a big welcome, if you would, for our hostess. Here comes the lovely Banna White. Oh, Banna! Now we have a few nice folks for you to meet. I assume you're all nice folks.
Yes?
Okay, there's general agreement on that. This is Renee Humboldt. From Glendale, Arizona.
Right.
Near Phoenix, as I recall, right?
Outskirts.
Yeah, right. What do you do back in Glendale, Renee?
I'm a housewife, and I have two boys, Justin 6 and Chances 3.
Work that in very nicely.
Yes.
It says you enjoy bowling, and you do some coaching for one of the sons.
My oldest son's soccer team, yes.
Yeah, nice to have you here,
Thank
Renee.
You.
Good luck
nice
to you.
Nice to be here. Thank you.
Let's see, Helena Naglak. Did I get that right?
Yeah.
What's the derivation of that name, Helena?
Polish.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Well, Yakshimash, as we say.
Yaktam.
I think we just ordered something. I'm not sure. Helena's from Palmer, Massachusetts. That's near Boston, I believe.
Near to Springfield.
Ah, well, it's pretty close to Boston. It's closer to Boston,
right.
Say, Glendale. Whew, got out of that one. Helena is a high school teacher back there. You have one child at home.
Yes, Jody. He's 6. Mm-hmm. He's in the audience.
And hi, Jody. Nope, nothing. I think Jody left, Helena. No, he's out there. Lots of luck on our show.
Thank you.
And talk about interesting names. Galen Scammahorn is with us from East Alton, Illinois.
Right.
I won't guess where that's near. You tell me.
That's right near St. Louis.
I got it. That would have been my guess, too. Doggone it. What kind of name is Scammahorn, Galen?
It's Holland Dutch.
Gotcha. And let's see, you're a church choir director back there.
Yes, I am.
You enjoy golf and tennis.
Right.
We have to have an Al Johnson week here and give the host a break. This is getting rough. All right, let's get going. $1,000, top dollar value for this round. Try not to hit bankrupt. Do you lose your cash but not your merchandise? Because once you buy a prize, it's yours to keep. Our first puzzle is a phrase. Now, just before the show, we drew numbers to see who would start the game. Renee, it's going to be you. Good luck, everybody. Let's go.
Okay, here we go. Come on. Take it.
$200.
Okay, I would like an R, please.
There is an R, yes. Okay.
Let's go, come on, big money, let's go.
$200.
Okay, is there a T as in Tom, please?
There is a T, in fact, let's see, two of them.
On this spin. Let's go, come on, big money.
$175.
May I have an S as in Sam, please?
Uh-huh, there are two S's.
Okay, I'd like to buy a vowel, please.
All right.
I'd like an O.
Three O's for your $250. Renee, you're down to $700, but it is still your turn.
Okay, I'll spin.
Okay.
Come on, big money. Go.
$600.
May I have an F as in Frank, please?
Yes, one F. Now, Renee, $1,300.
I'm going to have to spin.
Okay.
Let's go. Come on, big money.
I'm sorry, Renee.
Okay.
Renee, big break for you. $400.
An M, please.
Sure, one M. That's $400. You going again?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm sorry, a lot of bad luck out here so far. Galen, it's your turn. $350.
I'd like a P as in Paul.
Give him a P. Now you have $350. See if you can hold on to it. You want to do?
I'll spin.
Okay. $400.
I'd like an N as in Nancy.
I believe there's an N, yes. Now, again, you have $750 if you can solve this puzzle.
I'd like to solve it from soup to nuts.
Yes, there you go. Kind of a strange round there, huh? Yeah, well, happy ending for you from soup to nuts. $750. We're going to walk into the library and spend it all there. What would you like?
For $300, I'd like the silver tea and coffee set.
All right, you have $450 left.
For $170, I'll take the lamps.
Okay, the lamps are yours, and $280 to go. One of two things.
The grass plant stand.
All right, $270 the price on that. $10 left. gift certificate or on account? How would you like it?
I'll take it on a gift certificate.
Okay, that'll be an American Express catalog gift certificate. Here's Jack with those prizes.
And away we go, Pat. Well, Galen, first of all, it's AlciCycle 2's pair of classic ginger jar lamps, three-way turn switch, and natural linen shirred shades by AlciCycle 2, $170. And then a charming plant stand, solid brass, protected by baked clear enamel, wipes clean with a damp cloth from Swan Products, $270. And finally, Leonard Silver's footed silver-plated five-piece tea and coffee set. Tray, coffee pot, teapot, sugar bowl, and creamer, all by Leonard Silver Manufacturing Company. $300.
Okay. All right, let's make a pact. No more bankrupts, no more lose returns. But we do have some more commercials, and we'll be right back.
Jump on the merry-go-round of savings during the Great American Food Fest of National Brands.
Save more with Eagle Key Buy prices on Borden's Real Lemon Juice, a 32-ounce bottle, just $1.54. Weiler's Bouillon Cubes, a 25-count package, just 96 cents. And Eagle Brand Condensed Milk, 14.5 ounces, just $1.26.
Join the big top circus of values going on now at Eagle Food Centers.
Plymouth engineers a new 550 Reliant K, the Reliant Super K.
Match it.
The best six-passenger car value. Backed with 550 protection. Aerodynamically redesigned to be more efficient. We made the best better. 550 Reliant, the Super K. Match it if you can. Plymouth, best built, best backed American cars.
Oh, hi there. Are we back already? My goodness, time flies. Round two. We still have $1,000 on the wheel and a pretty nice prize out there, too. Here's Jack with the tales.
Right, Pat. I'd like this myself. It's a trip to Hawaii. Now, we'll fly you and a guest from Los Angeles to the island of Maui, where you'll stay at the Maui Surf Resort Hotel on the sands of Ka'anapali Beach in Hawaii, offering golf and tennis, quality guest accommodations, dancing, and island entertainment at the Maui Surf. Retail value, $1,834.
One of our players lands in the special prize and, of course, going to the bank. And if they solve the puzzle, it will become theirs. And now our next puzzle is a phrase. Round two means player two starts. Helena. $700.
I'd like an S, please.
No, pray not. Galen. Come on, Galen.
All right, big money. Big money.
$800.
I'd like an R, please.
There is an R. In fact, there are two of them. That's a quick $1,600.
I'll spin.
Okay. $400.
I'd like a T, please.
Is there a no? Pray not. Renee.
One trip.
$250.
I would like a D, please, as in dog.
Nope, no D. Helena, back to you. That's a nice one, $900.
I'd like a G, please.
But we can't give you anything. No G. Galen. Well, we've spread the bad luck around, haven't we? I'm sorry, Galen. The money goes and the turn goes to you, Renee.
Okay.
Hit code, $800.
Okay, I would like an L, please.
No, no L. Having some problems here. Helena. $150, yeah.
I'd like an N, please.
There is no N either. Galen. $300.
I'd like a W.
Nope. We are using the standard English alphabet. I'd like to point it out. Renee.
Here we go. Come on. Come on, Trip. Come on.
$550.
I would like a Y, please.
There is a Y. There you go. That breaks the logjam there. Are you under?
Yes.
Okay.
Let's go. Come on, Big Money.
400.
May I have a B as in boy, please?
Afraid not. Helena. Oh. 400.
I'd like a P, please.
No, no P. Galen. $300.
I'd like a C.
Two C's. There you go. $600. What's going to be now?
I'd like to buy a vowel.
Which one?
An E.
There are some E's up there. Okay.
Again. I'll spin.
All right. Let's stop that wheel any time here now. $300.
I'd like a V.
Give him a V. $650.
I'd like to buy another vowel.
Okay.
An O.
Yeah, there is an O, but just that one. Okay. I don't know what that is. Still your turn. Still a 400.
I'll spin.
$200.
I'd like an H, please.
There is no H, and Renee, we go back to you. $400.
I would like a Q.
There may be one, yes. All right, Renee, you have $950.
I would like to solve the puzzle.
All right, what's this phrase?
Quick recovery.
I'll say, yes. Where it's been going, why gamble? I don't blame you. Oh, quick recovery. That's $950. That's good enough for the lead at this point.
Okay.
And you're going to spend it at the utility center.
For $549, the posture chair.
Okay, that's a great chair. You have $401 left.
For $399, the color TV.
And that's $2. A gift certificate, all right?
Gift certificate's fine with me.
A couple of very nice prizes. Here's Jack. Tell you about them.
Okay, Renee, first of all, you can enjoy watching all your favorite programs on Sharp's 13-inch diagonal portable color TV. It's 100% solid state with wireless remote control and automatic fine-tuning. Retail value $399. And then WestNofa's new concept in seating, the Balance Tripos, three chairs in one, forward into balance, middle for lounging, and all the way back for reclining. The Balance Tripos by WestNofa, $549.
Okay, nicely done. Third round with $5,000 placed on the wheel, so we may see some big bucks then.
Meet a couple of picky eaters. Mom says they take after me. Seems I spent more time wrinkling my nose at the table than eating, except for when we had sausage. Of course, I'd have to eat Bob Evans. You couldn't fool me with another brand, and I can't fool them. Maybe it's because Bob Evans is made from such good cuts of meat, and you can't buy fresher. Sure, there's cheaper, but I haven't saved a thing if they wrinkle up their noses.
Bob Evans, great taste from down on the farm, now in Brown and Serve.
You're gonna love the way we're gonna make your day.
If you get two of the same gifts or want to return something for any reason, at Zaire, we'll take it back with a smile.
Sure, want to get something else?
Come along and see that Zaire, yeah.
We'd like to make Zaire your store.
Well, Zaire. I just made Zaire my store.
I couldn't help but note that arthritis there. One of the things I've fought for is doing research on arthritis and cancer and cystic fibrosis. It may not come for you or for me, but if we can do it for our children, that's important.
Paul Simon is not only supporting research on the diseases that strike the elderly, but is fighting to stop politicians like Charles Percy, who have called Medicare forced insurance and have voted to cut Social Security by $40 billion. Paul Simon. A senator we can count on.
It was worth the wait. Eight presidents and a man on the moon later, Cub fans have a winner.
It's a tribute to you. You're the reason why.
All through this unforgettable summer, the 1984 Cubs have lived up to the standards you deserve. And we've been proud to capture it all on sports pages that live up to these same high standards.
It's a tribute to you, the Chicago Tribune.
Third round, we have a $5,000 space out there on the wheel. Let's see if we can't get it here. We're looking for things. That's our category. And Galen, you'll do the honors. $400.
Like an S's in Sam.
We have two S's. You have $800. There they are.
That's Finn.
$200.
Like an R as in Robert.
Give him two R's. $1,200.
That's Finn. Like a T is in Tom.
There are two T's, and two by two they come. You have $2,400 now.
I'd like to buy a vowel.
Okay.
I'd like to buy an E.
Guess how many? Two. There they are. Galen?
I'll spit.
Okay.
$250. I'd like to buy an N.
Well,
I'd like to have an N.
That's all right. Doesn't matter. The point is, there is an N. $2,400.
I'd like to buy another vowel.
Okay.
An A.
Well, there's just one A, but that keeps it going for you. $2,150 again. What'll it be now?
I'll spit.
Okay. Hurry up. $700.
Ooh. I'd like a C, please.
Mm-hmm. There's a C. $2,850. A lot of money. What's it going to be?
I'll buy a vowel. Vowel. Okay. An I.
There are two of them. Now, you look at those eyes, and then you tell us what you're going to do next. Galen, quickly.
I'm going to buy another vowel, an okay. O.
There is one O. All right. Now what?
I'll spin.
Okay. $200.
I'd like a D.
I'm sorry, there is no D. Renee.
Okay, come on, Will. Come on, $5,000. Come on, $5,000.
Boy, that was close. $500.
I would like a B as in boy, please.
There is no B. Helena, it's your turn. Okay. Come on.
A P, please?
Yes, there's a P. $250. Now, that sound means time is running out, so it's up to me to give the wheel a final spin. I'll ask you to give me a letter. If it's in the puzzle, you'll have 5 seconds to solve it. Vowels worth nothing. Consonants worth... Ah, boy. Well, $300. Letter from you, Helena.
A G, please?
There is a G. Things.
I'd like to solve it.
Do it.
Grapefruit sections.
Yes, that's it. Oh, well. Grapefruit sections it is. Boy, we were one spike away from some pretty big money there. Still, you have $550 to spend. You'll do it in the TV room. What would you like in there?
For $400, the women's sportswear.
Okay, $150 left. That's a nice size gift certificate for you. And here's Jack Clark to describe in intimate detail the women's sportswear, I think, Jack.